Okay.
I don't know if everybody, oh, Jack, you haven't got a copy. Can I give you a copy of that?
You have mine.
No, I have not, I think.
Any questions? Yeah. This is 2 years old.
Just a couple of questions, but I think we'll discuss them during the meeting.
I'll make a motion, accept it.
We have a motion, is there a second?
Second.
Moved and seconded to accept the minutes of the November 9th meeting. All is in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? It's unanimous? Okay. So, as I mentioned, Tuesday, Brenda's available Tuesday, and she will bring everyone up to date on where we are with the budget process as far as collecting the data. And then I suspect it's going to be the same, you know, we will either have whoever the administrator is or somebody, whether it's me or the town administrator, will ask people to come in and present budgets. Is that what we're supposed to be doing, I think?
That's what, the 10th? Skip?
That's the 10th. It's Tuesday.
Tuesday, the 10th.
Yeah.
It's 7 p.m., so you'll have to get that posted tomorrow?
I will.
I'll have to get it posted at 8 o'clock in the morning.
I'm joking.
No, it's not funny. I, you know.
Yeah, it's a pain.
I call
Oh, it is a pain.
Last Thursday.
No, actually, it isn't that bad. I do it for the sewer study committee as an email. You just make the agenda out, and you attach it, and you email it to the three people that you get it, and just post it.
And hope they post it.
Well, that's not a problem. The problem was that I tried to mail it, or email out Thursday afternoon.
After they closed.
Oh, they closed.
After they closed. So that's the reason that we're meeting tonight and not Tuesday.
Understandable.
Yep.
And, you know, we could have met yesterday.
Just a question for that Tuesday at 7 o'clock start. If we're going to have a couple of members that are going to be attending other meetings and not going to be able to get here till later, should we kick that start time to 7:30? Not that I'll want it any later, but I'm just wondering if there's going to be information shared from Brenda that should be heard by all members.
Yeah, I don't think so.
You're going to be here Tuesday.
Yes. That you're gone for
I'm just going to my brother. He invited me out to eat.
Oh, okay.
So we're going to Florence to the Elks.
You saw the quorum.
You're not going to be
here? I will not be here Tuesday.
I'll be here at 8 o'clock-ish, but so I wouldn't hold anything up. I mean, I'll catch up when we get here.
It's strictly discussion. We're not going to make any
right. any decisions.
And if she has a handout or something, you know, that'd be fine.
Tuesday, a quorum?
But some,
it's a quorum. Anyway.
You will.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought you said that.
I'm still a quorum.
Someone will have to take
minutes. Okay, so leave it at 7 o'clock then?
What do you think?
3 or 1?
7 o'clock?
It's 3 years.
7 o'clock, 7:30, what do you want?
7 o'clock.
7 o'clock.
7.
Okay. 7 o'clock.
Okay.
Would it be better, you said, have like a department head come in and go over the budget at the same time? Would it be better if we could review the budget first instead of
Everybody will have the budget, and I don't know whether we'll have them all next Tuesday or not. I hope we have some.
So we'll have a chance to look at them
everyone will have the budget, so okay. Before the department heads come in.
Okay.
Can I ask a question about the department head's budget? Does that include, will it show what they're requesting for capital improvements?
No.
It will not.
I don't think so.
That's a capital improvements committee, man.
Yes, and I have a report here.
Great, so.
But that doesn't mean it's going to be interesting, because because I wonder how many capital requests that can be made without having gone to the capital.
That's my point, that was my point.
Well, we'll find out. I'm glad I'm on both committees this year.
Well, yes, it should be going.
Supposed to, yeah.
But they don't have to show on their budget capital expenditure.
Well, they don't, because they...
The ones that they report to.
The one they report to you have to be shown on their budget.
No.
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 Because it's a separate...
They're doing an operating budget, not a capital.
That's what I thought.
I mean, we get to vote on the...
We get to vote on the capital.
But we can do a cross-reference as we go along.
Yeah, you get to review it.
We could do a cross-reference as we go along.
You're gonna see it.
Operational budget and their capital budget.
No.
But you'll see.
I agree that we should, if possible, have a chance to review the budget prior to meeting with the department head.
Operating budget.
Do we know if there was talk about having them look at the budget with a 5% decrease? Was that done, or are they just simply doing their budget as in the past, and when we get the budget, we're gonna see what percentage they're looking for?
I don't remember what was in that memo.
We should have a copy of that memo, I think, if it refers to when budgets are gonna be submitted.
Because it kinda puts us in an awkward...
Well, I'll have Brenda, if she's in tomorrow, I'm not sure she's in, but I'll take a look and see if I've got one at home.
I just think any correspondence relates to what we're doing, we should have.
I mean, I got one because she was asking for a budget for the finance committee, and I just got $500 number and stuff and sent it back to her. So someplace there is...
That's a 100% increase.
So what?
100% increase.
No, it's only 70% increase.
We haven't bought that yet, have we?
Well, the reason why I ask, though, is it puts us, or could put us in a difficult position when we're trying to ask questions about budgets and that, thinking that everybody was supposed to hold a 2%, and somebody's sitting there with 6% increase, and all of a sudden find out, well, no, nothing was ever said.
I'll check and see what I've got, and then if there's nothing in there that looks like it, talking about a percentage increase, then I will check with, probably on Monday. With Brenda or check with Board of Selectmen.
The problem is that when the Board of Selectmen are supposed to write out this policy...
That's what I thought.
They're supposed to do it like in November at the latest.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And the reason for that is that way they can say, this is what we want to see, this is what we have, because if you don't do it by now, it's already too late.
Oh, yeah.
The schools have already figured out what they want. They're going to ask for whatever they can want, and they don't care.
They're doing the budget right now.
That's the problem. The problem is that if the guidance doesn't come out early, we don't get it. We're going to deal with the same problem we do every year.
They're going to deal with everything from the deal.
That's anyway. Right.
Well, so you know what happens with it when that memo goes to the superintendent's office. they're going to ignore it. And there's both here and tech school, wherever. But there's 2/3 of the budget.
But I know the two schools that we have any jurisdiction over do have 5-year capital plans. And they've been presented at the meetings.
Who has?
Deerfield Elementary School and Frontier.
Yeah, it's interesting. That's...
I understand. I'm bringing it to the table.
Okay. So, they never gave it to CIPC.
They're going to bring it when they submit the budget. They're going to request warrant articles.
They're talking about that statute if you want to.
No.
You don't want to say anything. Okay.
What, for fiscal year 18?
They're going to send warrant articles to the selectmen for their approval, which will be capital improvements.
They're not going to the selectmen.
I understand that. But they're going to create warrant articles.
The town bylaws say that no capital expenditures
so if you have a chance,
without being reviewed by CIPC.
Review the last two meetings of the Deerfield and Frontier School Committee.
I don't doubt it.
Yeah,
I'm just saying
this is what their process, they believe their process is.
I find that interesting because the Capital Improvement Plan Committee put requests out. to the schools.
Got no response.
For, right, and ended up with no responses.
They didn't have a complaint until last month, this month? No, January, December. When they knew they had to submit them to you, they said that.
They were asked last May, by Carolyn.
Brings up the point.
And she asked again.
Brings up the point about a lot of things with sewer and all of the charges. Okay, yeah, but the policy was never set, according to you, not John, for this?
I haven't, I asked that a couple of months ago, and I haven't seen anything since.
The Board of Selectmen's policy.
For the Board of Selectmen.
For the Board of Selectmen.
For the budget.
The operating budget of capital.
Operating.
We don't have a bylaw that already says it's supposed to go to CIP?
Yes.
Yeah, so then CIP.
But the memo went out.
Saying what is left?
Said we want it by, it has to be by December 1.
And you have nothing.
Not from the schools.
That's how they did the roof.
That was a week before.
Yeah, that was a year ago.
Yep, another example of the selectmen stepping in where they.
Well, I don't think it's, I think it's the lack of knowledge of the two school committees who are being directed by their administration. You watched the meetings and you can make a determination.
Well, I'm gonna take exception to that, because Ken Cuddeback is the chair of the school committee, right?
No, not anymore.
He was. But he's also on the CIPC.
Certainly knew.
So he's on both.
That's right.
So he should know.
Of course he should know.
They all should.
And one of the reasons that there's a member from the school committee on the CIPC is to have that communication.
Right.
No response.
It still amounts to they've gotten away with it every year on town meeting floor, so therefore, why worry about it?
Well, they haven't had capital requests. They did have, there was a capital request from Frontier back, what year was that? Remember they came in with that $3 million or $5 million, whatever it was?
There's a discussion.
We managed to bury it.
There's a discussion whether they need, want to go to the fast track like they did the school roof in Deerfield.
We don't do Frontier, though.
Yes, you do. We own Frontier.
Because it's a budget. Comes.
So we own the building.
Large.
No, I don't know.
No. No, we only own a portion of it.
It's a separate district. It's a separate district.
Yeah.
It's fine. Is the elementary school a separate district?
Right, but it's supposed to go, you know, anything like that, supposed to go all four towns' capital improvement.
It's not like they have taxing authority. The South Deerfield Fire Department is taxing authority, so they won't submit anything to us. We don't want it anyways.
Right.
So the high school has taxing authority?
No.
No.
Oh, just assessing authority?
They don't have.
Okay.
They don't have assessing authority. That's it. It's in.
They have to get a vote, positive vote from three out of four towns to have a budget approved.
Because it's regional.
Okay. Want to go with this?
Yes, I do.
I have.
Oh, by the way, I've got this, which is the end of month report for November.
Yeah, that's the last one I've seen too.
That is the last one as well.
So I will ask for December one, and we'll have it next.
I have a report of the CIPC to date. Take one and I'll discuss it, how it works. What's that mean now? The first three columns, the first one tells the department, the second column from the left says some comments. Then the next three columns are what was requested to CIPC, what's been approved by CIP, and what hasn't been reviewed by the CIPC. And the fourth column on the right represents the library, which hasn't been requested yet, but based on a meeting that they had with us, we anticipate it'll be at. So I put it down here. So I can go line by line, or do you want to just look at totals?
No, let's go line by line.
All right. The Board of selectmen, type of, the town hall department. Brenda, right, wants a new, would like a new voting machine?
Actually, Barbara.
Barbara, okay, I don't know how to use it. For $6,500, we haven't reviewed it yet. Our next CIPC meeting, Barbara's gonna come in and explain the need of it. We're hoping that we may be able to wait for a future year on that.
Does the state kick in any money for a voting machine?
No.
It's all in the town?
It's all in the town, and this is the same price as what we paid for the one we got 12 years ago. No, you can't. You really should have two.
Prior to the request.
You should have two.
Prior to the request, and the justification was that this machine no longer receives or can receive the updates that's required.
Planned out to lessons.
Right, yeah.
You're talking about the one, you put it in the crank?
Hematite.
I mean, the one, the existing one?
Where it's on hand.
Yeah, to replace the existing one, yeah.
I didn't think that had any communication with anybody, other than somebody turned the handle.
Well, they all did that.
No, it was last time, was there some electronic one? Right, there's an electronic one.
Been there for a dozen years.
Right.
Okay, you put it in, it looks the same old box.
No, it's.
Nothing dated, nothing dated anymore.
Right, I think that's probably.
And there isn't a crank.
No, but somebody stands there and makes sure.
Mary used to stand there and go like this every time they came.
I remember.
Yeah, you and Bill used to take turns.
Okay.
And make sure it does not have electronic capability, so we can't get it hacked.
Right, so I think it should be a crank.
We still got the old one, if you wanna go out there and crank it, and count the ballots like 3 and 4 o'clock in the morning.
I was wondering how we got the answer so quick.
Okay, the next line item is Kevin Scarborough put a request for appropriation to repair the salt shed roof and front door. He did a wild guess of $37,000. The committee approved it, subject to him coming in with a better quote, getting some quotes. So the need for it's been approved, the amount is not. Because he didn't know.
That's a transfer station.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's at the transfer station.
Yeah, so he wanted to put.
Two salt storage areas?
I don't know.
Yeah, there's one down here.
One down at the new highway garage, and what is the one used up at the highway garage for?
Salt.
Salt and storage of some other goods, Kevin said.
So he's coming to our next meeting with a better amount, more accurate quote.
As long as it's still structurally sound, they weren't built that well when they were all off by the state.
Well, I guess it is and it isn't, it needs.
The roof.
Yeah.
The roof is pretty much the building.
Well, yeah, except for the concrete. I don't know if they need to replace all of the.
No, just framing, basically the exterior, the roof frame in itself is pretty good, the, around the.
The front door, entrance door needs, right.
That's all rotten.
Right, that needs help, right, yeah.
Is it, has anybody looked at the concrete floor?
Well, I don't think it's CIPC's job to go around and look at things to see if things they might be needed, it's up to the department.
Just asking, my question.
No, no, question.
Do they really need it, because they've got the new one over here?
Well, I would question whether or not it's a safe place for storage, that would be my question, that's all.
Correct.
If the concrete is deteriorated to the point where we're leaching salt into the ground, maybe it needs a new floor also.
That would be up to Kevin.
Falls off.
Well, the other thing is he was trying to convince them to start looking at brine.
Yeah.
For a road besides.
Right.
Right.
I agree.
Not that they should let it be, let it fall apart.
No, I agree, it shouldn't.
Nothing else that can be used for storing equipment, you know.
We need storage in this town, period.
Winter time, summer equipment goes up there, summertime, winter equipment goes up there.
Right.
Nothing else, it's under shelter.
Yeah.
Yeah, they've had a truck outside for the last year.
Well, that one feels nice, it's supposed to be on the schedule.
How many plows do they have sitting out down? I haven't counted recently.
Okay, so then, Mike, I just think it's a lot of money.
Next line item is $57,000 was requested to CIPC for future replacement of an ambulance, and we approved that, and that's like setting aside money every year.
That's not correct.
How many years?
$57,000 times 5 years, that's $285,000, which you're paying for a new one right now.
This is just the town's share.
That's, no, that's the point.
What I'm saying is, that's a full share, that's not a town share.
It says, amount is the town share.
Did I put down the wrong?
I know what it said, but it's not right, that's what I'm saying.
Let me check, hold on.
You're telling me that a town share is $285,000, and we're gonna have a new ambulance every 5 years?
No, it shouldn't be.
That's incorrect.
That's not the town share, that was the total cost.
52%, did I do it wrong?
52%.
That was the total cost, yeah.
Yeah, that'd be my impression. We have to, they set the money aside every year, the same amount.
Yeah.
Right.
Because I know they have about $300,000 trying to figure out what to do with.
Yeah, that's, that notation, yeah, that's.
52%?
It should be half that, so that's my error.
About the other two items below that.
Same thing.
What did they say?
Should be.
52%.
52%. That's the total.
No, the other, the $10,005 is half.
Oh, that is, okay.
It's half?
That is half.
Okay.
For the administration pump and.
The cot is half also, because they're looking, I think, for 20.
The cot's half too, yeah.
For two, they're looking for two cots.
So my apologies on the ambulance, that should be $28,500.
Okay, so the other two are proper?
Yes.
The other town share only?
Yes.
Yep.
So as line items, okay, the $57,000 should be $28,500.
Or thereabouts.
Yeah, well, no, that's, it's set aside.
52%.
Yeah,
That's what I meant.
Yes, I use 50% for, like, 50, I don't know, 52%, I guess.
I think it was.
Is it 52?
It's over 50.
Yeah, it's like 51 point something.
Yeah, barely over. Anyway, they needed a pump, medication administration pump, to pump IV instead of letting it drip in, and that's required by state.
Right, yeah.
And they're not gonna buy it yet, they're waiting, because hopefully, since the state mandated it, the manufacturer's gonna be making a lot of them, and.
Price may come down.
A lot of them, price may come down.
So how does this work with skims? You approve their capital expenditures, then they appropriate them, and when they come to us? Because this would be included in their budget.
Yes, someplace.
Someplace in their budget, they're gonna show that they're putting aside money for capital expenditures and medical expenditures, because they can do that as an enterprise.
I think the question that we need to take a look at or ask there is whether or not they have money in the budget this year.
They do, $314,000.
How much?
$314,000.
Well, that's in retained earnings, they can't spend those $500,000.
Retained earnings.
No, it's down, with the ambulance and stuff out, it's down.
They took $300,000 out, they started with $800,000.
I know.
But they have $314,000 now in retained earnings.
Right.
And they're trying to figure out how to spend that without giving all of that back.
That's the problem, they keep wanting to spend, they don't care what they got, just keep giving more.
There's three options, I believe, no? I'm not sure, I know two. One was put more money towards the ambulance, and one was to give a portion, some money back to the town as an abatement.
They don't have to give anybody money back, all they have to do is reduce their budget.
That's what.
That's all they have to do.
I guess that's what.
And let them hang on to the retained earnings that they already have.
The
problem is they don't have to manage, that's the issue.
They can't spend the retained earnings unless they appropriate from it for some reason.
That's right.
And that has to come through.
That has to come through us.
Through us and through the town meeting.
Right, yeah.
So, for example, ambulance, maybe we don't need to appropriate $57,000, or maybe, you know, your recommendation is to take the $57,000 from retained earnings.
Right. That's why I was.
No.
No, you just approve it, right?
We're just approving it. We don't say where it comes from.
I think we say where it comes from.
All right, but we can do that.
Because I think we, the Board of Oversight in Town Deerfield, being the financial agent, should make a recommendation.
Board of Oversight can
And the financial, and the financial manager of SCIMS, which is us, which is Carolyn, should make a recommendation to the board of how the retained earnings should be spent, not the other way around.
Well, we can take a look at it and.
Would we take the total amount? We'd take the total amount for the, you know, it's 57 for the retained earnings, not just Deerfield.
Yeah, yeah, we take everything out, 57.
But would it come out of retained earnings or would it be voted?
Well, either way, it's going to be voted.
Either way.
Yeah. I mean, raised through taxes.
And, you know, each town would have to vote to 57.
Either way, it would, if you're.
I think.
You could reduce.
Maybe not, but whatever.
Assessment.
I think would be.
The way our agreement is set up now is that they have to establish a budget, submit it to the town of Deerfield. The finance committee has to approve it because the other two town committees don't have the right to approve it. Sunderland, Whately don't approve it. That's what the agreement says. That the financial overseer for SCIMS is right here.
All they vote on is.
All they vote on is a one line item saying your assessment is blank. That's all they vote.
They don't vote on the line items.
Well, we don't,
We vote on a line item too, but we have input into it.
When we go to town meeting, there's only one number.
Right.
Now, in this case, for the, maybe there's two numbers. There's one for operating and one for capital.
Now we've had only one number because they're an enterprise fund.
It does not have to be.
But they don't have to separate it out. But I think we should keep an eye on what they have because we had the same kind of money left over the second year as we had the first year. And the reason they're buying the ambulance this year instead of buying it next year was because they had so much money, they figured let's push it through.
Right.
And the problem is that they're already running the same way the schools do. Oh, we got the money, let's spend it. Well, let's not give anything back, let's keep our assessment the same. And we got to make sure that we watch that because they're not.
I don't believe that we have to submit this to the townspeople. It's a single budget. I believe it's going to be done the same as the omnibus budget, if we prefer, as a line item so that they cannot transfer amongst themselves and move things around.
With the enterprise fund?
Such as last year, if you go through, Zach's salary was over budget on his line item. I do not believe that, even as an enterprise, I think the only ones that are exempt from, that have to have a full budget is the schools, that you have no say on. But any other budget, whether it be Kevin's, ours, or anybody else, it can be presented as a line-by-line budget, the same as the omnibus.
The budget that...
That's why, when I understand.
The budget that we see here from department heads,
right,
when it gets finished with whatever procedures you've got,
detail.
When Brenda gets it, she puts it in just that way into the now.
But I'm saying we have the right to request it be done as a line item budget.
Well, that would be a line item.
Right.
The thing is, the individual
within the budget.
Well, a department head can move money within the you know, there's basically two areas. You got salary, and you've got whatever you call the other one, general operations.
Right.
The department head's always been able to move money around within those. They can't go between salary and that has to come. If it's small enough, it can come here and we can approve that.
Right.
If not, then it would have to go to a town meeting. So. But there's just two numbers, basically. You got the operating expense and you got salaries.
So on those line items for last year.
No, I don't know about SCIMS.
It is last year's.
For.
And all, yeah. What is it, just one number?
Oh, yeah. That's the way it was presented. But when these departments are running over their line items on particular salaries, where's that coming from?
There shouldn't be.
The library did that, and Zach's payroll did that.
Not
Not by much, but it's still.
Well, his payroll was broken up into three or four different things. And within that payroll, he can move, he can overspend as long as he's underspending everywhere else.
Because he has full-time officers, part-time, you know, call.
No, no, I'm talking about his line item salary.
His personal.
He has a separate line item salary.
For the director. Yeah, well, actually it is, and it's in there that way, but it's part of salaries. And that, so, yeah, there is a bit of a problem. They, you know, it's the selectmen have raised salaries without telling, without ever going to the personnel committee.
The library did the same thing. Almost every one of their employees, they ran a negative on their budget line for each one of their employees.
Which, last year?
Yep.
16?
Yep.
We're in 17 now.
Right.
And they never, and so at the end of the year, their set total salaries exceeded what they had budgeted.
Well, that I don't.
No, the total salary didn't, because they're part-time salaries.
Yeah, they're part-time salaries, but each individual one evidently had a line item budget.
Well, it's presented.
Well, it wasn't presented that way, but it wasn't.
Or 17, I don't know that we've got, I've never got 17 here.
I thought the library was a separate article.
Is a culture and recreation, Tilton Library, $157,000.
It's a separate line, it's a line item.
It's a line item. All right, next.
Okay, so that takes care, we talked about the administration's office mandated by the state. Then they powered the ambulance cart loader. Instead of the guys picking up the gurneys and sliding, it's a powered thing.
It's two of them.
Is that one or two?
Two.
Two.
There's one each for each.
Right.
The new ambulance is coming with a cot, and they're getting two additional cots.
Which can be.
For the three ambulances, for the two backups.
And they can be moved.
And they can be adaptable, right.
For the next ambulance.
The next ambulance.
The next item was, this has not been approved by CIPC, but I received a phone call from Kip one day that they had an opportunity to replace the Ford Explorer with a Ford Escape that's used by the building inspector, the Board of Health, and the task force officer that would be donated.
Yeah.
And so I made a command decision to say go ahead and get it before the CIPC approved it so we could get the donation.
Yeah.
So I hope.
And it zeroed itself out.
It zeroed itself out.
Good question. I have no idea whether it's legitimate or not, but it certainly would be what I would have done. So.
Yeah, me too. I'm not going to throw away
$25,000. I think it was less than 25 too. So there's money left in.
There was a trade-in of $1,000 or something.
Yeah, but I think there's money left in that donation.
Oh, is there? I haven't seen real numbers.
From what I understand, they did it for less than $25,000.
So the things that went to the committee, forget the totals because it changes because of my mistake on the ambulance. So the total requested was $92,500. I'm using 50% instead of 51.76% for Skims. 86 was approved, and 6,500 has yet to be approved. So it's a pretty low year.
What is the total percentage for this?
51.76 plus 56.
762?
51.76.
So it's a pretty low year. Unless.
As of now.
As of now, well. Yeah, right.
Are you having anything from the highway department for sewer improvements?
No, it says it includes sewer, because I don't know, who knows? It doesn't include anybody that's going to do it, put in capital expenditures, and just buy their operating budget. Or they're just going to do it.
Schools.
Are there no? But.
I wonder if the town has any capital. Don't they usually have something that they throw in?
The town?
The town for.
Town hall?
Yeah.
about town as a whole.
A lot of times that comes through Kevin's budget.
No, last year Doug Finn said, oh, we have this building maintenance fund.
Yes.
And he said, we had like 92,000. And he said, let's start spending it. So that came through very late, but it was money that was already set aside, if that's what you're referring to.
It used to be self-insured. The money that was left in the municipal building fund is the money left over from when we were
self-insured.
Is there anything in 19 requests that potentially could be moved to 18? Even out the...
Yeah, well, one of the things that we...
Had nothing's come to us, our attention.
We had talked about doing, and I didn't have a problem, I don't know about anyone here, probably to me, or you, was setting up that capital improvement stabilization fund. Yep. With the idea that what we'd end up doing is putting a fixed amount into it on an annual basis, whether it's 100,000 or 250,000. And that's basically where you would end up drawing the money from to cover the budget. But that would be starting next year,
We could start it this year if we wanted.
Well, we would start it this year, but it would be for the 2019.
Oh, to be used.
Right.
Yes.
To draw from.
Yeah. So we'd have to fund both.
Right.
So it's nice to have a small number, and maybe we can afford it.
Yeah, it's a good year to start.
Yeah.
But I don't know if we can, if you're going to do that, say 200,000 every year, you're going to have to go raise money through taxes for that.
Or use free cash.
Free cash,
which we do now. I mean, that's what. But the idea was, if we could level that off so that we didn't have the spikes, so the fund builds up, $100,000. So if the fund gets to the point where it's got $500,000 into it, then I don't think that it makes much sense to keep putting money into it. But if you're sitting there with 5 years from now, you got $250,000 into it.
I'm all for it, but I don't see how we can get it started. If we put in 100,000, say this year, and the request next year, or 150,000, we're essentially back to zero again.
But we would end up funding, an annual appropriation of whatever the number is. Call it 200,000, just for round figures.
The first year, put in double.
You actually don't. First year, you put in 200,000, you don't touch it, and then you pay for this separately.
Taxation.
And then a year from now, you put another 200,000 into it, but you're going to draw down whatever the
capital request.
Right. I understand. Yeah.
So I thought it was reasonable. I didn't necessarily.
I think it's a good idea because then you're using your free cash, and you'll be able to watch how rather than have it in.
And if we could get to the point where we can
level it out
a little bit instead of having ups and downs.
I hope the CIPC, we're going to work towards a true 5-year plan. Forever plan.
Right.
Not 5 years.
Well,
recurring.
It's got to be reviewed every year and updated every year.
The goal is that everything we own that's in the fixed asset books, we're going to take and we say, okay, when do we have to replace it and how much?
Mm-hmm.
15 years from now, maybe 2 years.
Yep.
So we'll see.
That's great.
And we have a column for each year.
Well, for example, I'm not sure that it makes much sense to talk about replacing the school building in the year 20,000 or 2092.
No, we're going to do components of building, roofs, windows, doors, heating systems.
Yep.
Okay. Well, do we think that it's going to need a new heating system?
I don't know. Kevin and we'll talk to
Kevin. It's on their 5-year plan, elementary school to do some work.
But at least it's going to be discussed and looked. I'm not saying there's going to be an amount for it, but at least we're going to be looking at it. So maybe, but
instead of at the 11th hour saying, oh, by the way, we need a new heat system, and where's the money coming from? At least we'll have an idea what's coming down the road.
It's not going to be perfect, but it'll give us an idea. It'll also give us an idea if we do stabilization where the peaks and the valleys are.
Mm-hmm.
You have to approve a gift from a individual to be used.
CIPC? We don't do any votes for funding. We just approve.
What if it's.
Yeah, it's okay.
Or a gift comes in.
Gift comes in from, of a building.
Yeah. No, no. We approve the building.
Good, you approve the building. I don't know what the town at some point in time.
You accept it as a gift.
I think the town has.
The town would accept it as a gift.
I think so.
Yeah.
We'd come back to you with a five-year plan for maintenance and upkeep, and now it's a town building.
Not for maintenance.
Well, not for major improvements.
Well, we consider.
You consider roof, windows, you do all that.
Well, it's gonna be very interesting to anybody who listened to the last one, you know, because they're talking about putting that in a separate fund also.
I heard that.
Any to rent.
Right, I heard that. That's why. I don't know.
I think we're gonna have a battle with the attorneys before this is all done.
I think it probably will too.
Would you say that again, or?
But supposedly they wanna put this in a separate, the rent into a separate fund.
Specifically for any improvements, replacements, additions to that building. O&M and capital improvements.
If you take what they're asking for, $36,000 a year, and put it into a separate fund, after 3 years, they won't need more than $5,000 or $10,000 for either radio antennas or stuff like that. You'll have $100,000 in there in 3 years.
And the day they move in, they want it twice as big.
Yeah.
And that one, what they ought to do is with that, they should have fired the director.
Keep it going.
Yeah, let's leave that one alone.
and everyone else on that board.
No, actually,
didn't
it was fought.
Did I say there's been a problem with management there?
There was fought.
No, I wouldn't say that, was, would I?
Definitely fought by several of the
Oversight
members.
First of all.
I was glad to see Tom Fite and Kevin spoke up about that one.
That building.
Great.
Yeah.
As far as I know, is a town building, ultimately, not a building of the South County EMS.
That's correct. It's a town building.
So the money that comes into it comes into the town. What this town decides to do with it.
Whether they set up an account, whether we set up a stabilization fund for it.
Well, whatever they do, but it's this town's.
Oh, it's town money.
Yeah, you're right, you're right.
And we pay 52% of the $36,000, so we're only getting
48%, really.
Maybe we shouldn't pay anything. Maybe we just say, all right, look, we're going to charge $36,000, we're just not going to pay.
There's something else on the agenda.
Yeah, let's get off this.
There's one other item on here. One other item that I think should be discussed, and that's the library. They're anticipating the town's share of the cost of the library expansion to be $3.919 million. They're trying to raise money to reduce that. I didn't know the amount, you know, who knows how much they're going to get. But the timing of that is that the state will award grants next July.
Yep.
And if the state says, okay, Deerfield, you're going to get your money for 2018, but you have 6 months for to go to the voters of the town and have them appropriate our share, that means that there'll be a special town meeting,
right,
and it'll be appropriated fiscal year 2018, so.
I thought we were going to do a special town manager fund.
Or not.
We can't. I mean, we said we're not, but the regulations say within 6 months of your award, if you don't pony up the money.
You lose it.
You lose it.
Right.
And you move down on the list.
Right. So that's
it's every July, so it's not within our time frame anyway. So it's a debt exclusion for one thing, right?
I don't know. It depends on whether they're going to get a bond.
What?
Probably.
It doesn't matter.
I would think
bond,
so.
It doesn't matter whether it's bond or not.
But I'm just, how much do we have?
It would need to. It would presumably need to be a debt exclusion. There's no way that we can come up with.
No, we can't.
The money on it, even on a.
But don't
bond.
We have a limit on what we a borrowing limit?
Nope.
No debt limit?
Nope.
No debt limit?
We're having the voters to accept.
Yep.
Up to a point, and we're nowhere near that.
Well, that's all it's worth, isn't it?
There is a point, but we're nowhere near that.
Okay.
We're millions and millions and millions of dollars.
Oh, okay, fine.
So, but...
But in theory, the town could turn down a debt exclusion, or could pass a debt exclusion, vote the building, but not vote to bond it.
Understood.
So in theory, in that case, you'd have to go out and borrow the money, and basically you have 5 years to pay it off, the whole damn thing. So $800,000 a year plus...
5 year loan?
Yeah.
Well, it's 5 years only because the state starts complaining after 5 years that you need to do something.
And you have to
do something after 5 years.
You have to
actually
bond.
I think they might have changed that with that last municipal act.
You think really?
I thought they read something.
No.
I think with this grant, you have to bond the entire amount also.
Probably. Right.
The town has to...
Before we even get to that, the town voters are going to have to approve this.
Well, if it's brought up on a special meeting...
Right, but there's some concerns here. Number one, the town doesn't own the building. The town doesn't own the property. And also, when you talk 1,200 square feet, do you realize how big 1,200 square feet is?
12,000.
I mean, 12,000 square feet. Take a look at Sunderland's library. That's 6,500 square feet. Now you take a look at Deerfield, and that's going to be twice the size of Sunderland's library.
On top of that, you're looking at $30 million.
It'll be the same size, one floor, because they have two floors. So it's the same size as Sunderland's library, plus the existing library.
It's twice the size, right.
But it's in square, the footprint.
Right, the footprint would be
the same size.
But it's going to be twice the square footage,
means
you're going up one floor. So, and you also figure out the price per square foot on that.
That's the...
You think about that. You're talking $8,000 for this building for 12,000 square feet.
$8 million.
That'd be nice. But $8 million, and divide that by your 12,000 square feet.
It comes to just a little under $700 a square foot. So
$700.
And that 12,000
already incorporates the building.
Divided by 12,000.
So forget the 700. You're way over that.
$667 a square foot.
$667.
Now divide it by 9,000 square feet. Because that's the true addition. You're going to do some renovations, but you've already got 3,000 square feet existing.
Well, you're talking total.
And they want to take a CPA fund for that.
Yeah.
So you go 8 million, right, and divide it by 9,000.
Well, it's a lot of money, so
One thing that bothers me, and they said this was asked at the Finance Committee and at the CIPC, we asked how much, what are the operating expenses going to be?
They won't know.
And they don't know. Well, they keep saying, well, we don't think we're going to have to ask staff. We hope we don't. But then there was no discussion at all about more heat, more electricity, more maintenance.
More insurance. With a glass building, are we going to have a lot more maintenance, structural requirements over the years?
I haven't seen any indication from the people of the library presenters.
We won't. We won't. To be honest, the process doesn't allow this to happen. What happens when they're awarded the grant, the town votes the money, then the architect will take the sketches he has and start his schematic design and final bid ready plans and specs. Once he has schematic design, he'll have a better idea of what he's putting into the building.
I thought that was all done.
No.
Well, how did they come up with the cost?
I asked the question, and now that architects have built so many libraries and additions, they have estimators that say, based on this square footage and what your proposed improvements are, we figure that this is what each item costs. I give you a line item cost estimate.
But they're estimates.
Of course they're estimates. They're considered what's called WAGs. Estimate of probable costs.
So how can I as a taxpayer approve this.
You can't.
When I don't, no, no, how can I approve it when I don't know what the operating costs are gonna be to me as a tax? What am I gonna have to pay in taxes?
Yeah, but you're not.
You didn't know that with the highway garage.
I wasn't here then.
And I asked a question, I got no answer, and it still went through. Because the problem is you get a group that is in a small town, and it's democracy. You get a group of followers, and you load the floor.
So I mean, that's the problem with being the special town meeting, and I think it's.
More so in a special town meeting.
That's why.
And also, I think another problem is that people have a tendency to focus on one item instead of the bigger picture of all the additional costs that we have in town or will have in town.
And I think that, yes.
And I think that needs to be brought out. I mean, it's great, and I'm not saying I'm against library, I'm not anti-library, that's not the case. What I'm worried about with the town is we've got some pretty big bills coming down the road here,
yes.
And how is this all gonna fit into the same basket? And we all know that, I mean, everybody felt the impact of the town garage, and I'm not speaking poorly about the town garage either, but that was voted through, and then people were screaming, especially when, I remember I was at a school committee meeting, and some parents were screaming about how it was impacting the school budget, and if they had known, they would not have voted for the town garage, because they didn't realize the impact on the budget.
So because they had three half-year bills that they had to be paid in 1 year. That
right, that's why. So what happened was, I think once again, that I think we've got, maybe we as a committee need to expose that we have several costs that need to be considered before we just focus on one item and make a snap decision as far as a vote and commit to a, you know, fairly large dollar amount.
I think we should, there'll be hearings held. I think we should hold hearings, not us, the selectmen, should hold hearings on this project once, if it is awarded in July.
Well, obviously you're gonna hold hearings, but is it too late?
I mean, too late for?
You're either gonna say yes or no.
Who? When in July?
If.
No.
You got 6 months.
Got 6 months.
You gotta be notified first.
Right, they're gonna notify you of the award.
And then they'll tell you what year you'll chance of getting it.
Right.
Because it could be over the next 5 years. And then you're only gonna get part of that money each year, you don't get it all at once.
The question is.
You have to fund the full $8 million.
Whether there's a, we get anything back or not, we know roughly what the cost is gonna be. $8 million.
Oh yeah.
So we can sit down and figure out what that, and we can probably come up with a pretty close estimate of any staffing changes that are needed.
Or we just ask someone what their heating costs are. Double.
Well, you know, maybe the heating costs wouldn't be that much more than we're paying now, because presumably you're building it a little more
staffing costs.
I don't care if you build it more efficiently or not. If you're going from 3,000 square feet to 12,000 square feet.
It's the same designer, and Sunland was the same designer as the designer from Deerfield.
It is?
Supposedly, this is like nuclear glass, and it's going to not have much an energy impact. That's what was said.
They did away with the backside, the north side glass.
I don't get insurance. That's not even in their budget. Insurance is a separate part of the town budget.
We don't insure it on our building.
Yeah, well, we insure it.
Yeah, but who pays for it if it burns down?
That's part of the library budget.
Yeah. It is. Which is 157.
Which is funded by.
Okay. That'd be a good question. What their proposed insurance cost might be.
They won't know.
But my point was: is there any reason that we could not hold hearings? Somebody could hold hearings before the state ever said this is what.
I think it would be premature.
It's already been approved. The vote is approved. They're going to get a grant.
Right. Yeah. So when they get the grant, I think at that point in time, during that 6 month lead time we have to make a town, we have 6 months to either educate the community on what the true cost of the building.
right. It's, until that grant shows up, you're not going to get any interest in people.
Exactly. They're not going to get out.
At that point in time, you've got to let them know what the overall capital, not just for that is, but all the expenditures, right, as Jeff said. Now, and unfortunately, that's been part of the problem with every town meeting, is when the capital budget has been approved, it's only for that year, and it doesn't remind people what they voted the year before and the year before that they're already paying for the next, depending on what the debt term was.
20 years, 15 years, 10 years.
You know, 10, 20 years. They don't realize that they're already paying out X number of dollars, not to run the town and the school, but they're already paying for debt. And unfortunately, you know, we're a group right now, and the voters that show up at that town are putting this debt, many of them are putting a debt on the next generation without even thinking about the needs of the next generation. The next generation, for the most part, statistically, is not going to do as well as we have.
They won't even be here.
And we won't be here to,
the next generation,
to take the repercussions. So there's a whole different set of logistics in for the future. You know, that you know, people are just not paying attention.
We have our hearings. We should list everything that's debt excluded. So
right.
They see.
Yes, exactly, that's what I'm saying. It's all this.
Including
stuff that is not, that like we're still paying $95,000 a year for that Ashford property.
Exactly.
And we're going to still continue to pay that after we sell it.
No, it's paid.
Since when?
Since this year.
We paid it off, didn't we?
We paid it off.
Oxford?
Yeah.
No.
Which one did we pay off?
Yes. Paid off the energy loan.
I think we paid off Oxford.
No.
We're still paying $95,000 a year for the Oxford property.
Plus the interest.
And
okay, we did bond that, didn't we?
Yeah. Ultimately. Yes. And so that's not even under debt exclusion. That's in the regular budget.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so there's another $100,000.
We're being closed on the property.
Yeah, right. And even after we close, we're still going to be paying $95,000 for
we're receiving
another 10 or 12 years.
We're going to receive zero tax payment for a minimum, I think it's 5 years. If they sign this agreement, which sits out front there.
I thought they were only getting like a 5% tip. Are you serious? They didn't give much zero.
No tax at all, did they?
They had a standard tip we used to use at one time, and I used to.
Deficit percentage is in attachment A, which is now passed.
Well, we can go through that later.
Yeah. Okay. But I don't even know if it's signed. This was back in 2015.
No, I don't think it. And even if it was back then, I don't think. No. I mean, they could connect with the same thing.
So what strategy? Okay.
So anybody got any questions on the capital improvement budget?
I think it'd be interesting to see what shows up in our meetings, like you said.
Well, what's in the operating budget that's really capital?
Yeah.
Well, the one thing that's not there that I know is not there is the cruiser.
Well, the cruisers we've allowed to be in the operating budget.
Yeah, it's still, we are. It should be shown. It might as well be in capital. There's no reason not to.
It's repetitive. The capital improvement planning committee said make it operating because you do it every year. You get one every year.
Right. That's still.
That was the rationale.
Yeah, I did. And I probably was one of those that said you might as well put it in operating.
By definition, it should be.
Yeah. Well, it's the total dollar cost of $40,000 that, you know.
Well, the way the bylaw reads,
it says non-repetitive capital transactions.
Right. So that is a recurring expense, and that's why they opted to put it in operating. But if you're going to do that for that one, it should be for the ambulance.
Then you'd have to go all the way through it, right?
Well, the ambulance is
$50,000 every year.
But that goes from capital. Yeah.
So should the cruiser
$40,000
every year?
Well, I understand, but that's as John said, the bylaws say non-recurring.
Non-recurring, which means every year.
But the ambulance is they're setting aside.
Right.
Which is different than the purchase every year.
Well, no, they're trying to purchase every year at this point.
And they they got enough to fly a second one next year too.
Cruiser was 42.5.
All right, we got one more meeting.
Are you done yet?
Yeah, we done?
Yeah. So we're gonna meet next week and we'll have hopefully a schedule to, or what budgets are completed.
I don't know the schedule, but we should have, hopefully we'll have budgets.
And then we'll be scheduling a week, we're gonna stop meeting weekly?
We might as well, get it done and over with. When are you going on a trip?
17th.
Of February?
January.
I have warned you before I even started.
Yep, you did.
17th, you'll be back.
I don't remember.
March 7th.
That's fine, you only missed three.
So we're gonna meet every Tuesday?
We'll schedule the easy ones for the.
Now, the question is, who's going to pay for that device that we have to have so that he can talk to us every Tuesday?
You know, doesn't a cell phone have a speaker phone on it?
Yeah, but it's gotta be a special approved one by the state.
On your tablet, they have the Skype.
It doesn't say you have to have special approved, it's only gonna be approved by the committee.
Right, you read the information I sent you.
John, you're gonna be gone sometime in March.
No, but pretty much.
Part of February, part of March.
There are specific minutes.
Bring that up when it comes into February.
So everybody, audience can hear.
You'll have a board.
Right.
No, I mean, the selectmen.
So somebody make a motion?
Motion to adjourn.
Oh, yeah, is there a second?
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Anyone opposed?
Anybody ever opposed?
Yeah. Nope.